Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Basically this channel is developed to understand the basics of CATIA softwares. So CATIA is basically developed by the Dassault Systems, and we know that the long form of our CATIA is computer aided three-dimensional interactive applications. So this software is basically used for mechanical engineering, for designing of part component. So there are different types of tools are available in CATIA, or we can say the different types of workbenches are available in CATIA, like our sketcher, then part modeling, then assembly, then drafting, then sheet metal, generative sheet metal, then wireframe and surfacing. So all are the different types of module, or all are the different types of workbenches are used according to their special applications. So in this channel we'll learn how we are going to develop a product, how we are going to create a profile, how we are going to convert that profile into a part modeling, then how we are going to assemble the parts. So for that we'll start from very beginning and from very basics. So for that I kindly request you to subscribe my channel, and so I can provide a more videos in details. So let us start our CATIA session here. So at very first we have to start the CATIA window. So you can see here, this is our CATIA window. So by default it open as a product. So first of all we have to close this product window, then start mechanical design, part design. So it takes a little bit time. Then we can enter here our part name. So by default it is our part 1. So click on OK. Then you can see here again, this is the part modeling window. So this is our part name is part 1. On this you can see here, so there are the different types of planes are shown by the orange color. Then again on the left hand side, this is our hierarchical tree diagram. So here are the different types of planes are shown to you. So this is our XY plane, YZ plane, ZX plane. So on which we can create our profile. Then next thing is, this is our standard toolbar is provided here. On this standard toolbar, generally this toolbar is available in every software, and we know that the function of our standard toolbar is new, open, then again save, then quick print, then again cut, copy, paste, undo and redo. All are the standards, so which are available in every software. Then second toolbar is our view toolbar here. So in view toolbar is related to the aesthetic look of over this screen. So at very first we'll start our sketcher. So for going to start any profile, we should have to learn how we are going to draw the profile. So again we have to select a plane on which we have to create a profile. So suppose I am assuming that we have to create our profile on this plane, and this plane is our YZ plane, right? So again the very important tool is with us is that a sketcher toolbar. So this C is indicates here a sketcher. So just click on the sketch, then select the plane. So we are entering into our sketcher. Then again there are the different types of basic toolbars are available. So very first we learn a profile toolbar. So in this profile toolbar again different types of commands are provided. So very first one is a profile. So let us see our profile. just click left click on the profile, so it get activated. So according to that you can observe, after clicking on the profile again there is sketch tool is activated. Under sketch tool again there are the different types of options are shown here. So first one is our grid, second one is snap to point, third one is our construction standard element. So like that, according to our use we are just using all these options. So see here, our first one is our profile. So profile, just click the point where we need to draw the lines. Again according to that you can create a simple profile here. It is a continuous line, or you have to again observe, this is the major parameter. We need to read this command prompt, what input we need to feed there. So again just click or select the end point of the current line. So suppose I am just going to select, this is our end point. So this is our profile toolbar. Once again, profile, it is a continuous line, you can make it any direction like this one. So this is called as a profile tool. Then second tool is rectangle. So rectangle is defined under the predefined toolbar. So there is one small triangle, black color triangle is shown to us. So just click on the black triangle. So this is the very first is rectangle. So again in rectangle, so there are two points we have to specify. First one is horizontal and second one is vertical. So again click on the first point. So this is showing in a diagonal direction. So we are drawing a rectangle in a diagonal direction. So again see a rectangle, suppose this is the point, so this is a diagonal direction. Then if you want to delete all this, so just select it and delete it. Then next command is related to oriented rectangle. So select oriented rectangle, then again read the statement carefully here. Select a point or click to locate the start point. Suppose this is our start point. This is again select a point or click to locate the first side end point. So we have to give here the first side end point, so that that should be anywhere. So according to your profile, I'll just give it to this point, and now this is our rectangle. Once again, oriented rectangle, select a point or click to locate the start point. This is start point, then first side end point, and then again this is a rectangle. So this is called as our oriented rectangle. Then next one is parallelogram. So again parallelogram, select a point or click to locate the start point. We have to give the point, start point, then again first side end point, then in which directions we need a parallelogram. So according to that you can give the directions to the parallelogram. So this is regarding our parallelogram. Now next one is elongated holes. So in elongated holes, again we need to click on the elongated hole. So again define the center to center distance. Suppose this is our first point of center, again this is second point of our center, and give the radius of the center. This is our elongated hole. Again elongated hole, you can make in any direction. So this is first center point, second center point, and a radius. So this is regarding our elongated hole. Again I am just clear this screen. Next one is cylindrical elongated hole. Cylindrical elongated hole. So again, we have to define the center to center arc here. So center to center arc. So first one is center. This is a center to center arc. Then select a point or click to define the radius and the start point of the arc. So we have to define the start point of our arc. This is our start point of arc. This is our end point of arc, and then give the radius of our elongated holes. This is cylindrical elongated hole. Again, see here, cylindrical elongated hole. So center point is this one. Again, this is our start point, end point, and radius of elongated cylindrical hole. Now next one is again keyhole profile. So keyhole profile, we know that the function of our keyhole is again a profile which is made for the key purpose. So again, we have to select a point to locate the start point. Again, this is our start point, then small radius point. As we know that keyhole, a small radius is to the bottom side, so this is our bottom side. So this is our small radius, and again define the large radius here. We have to define the large radius. So this is our keyhole. Again, keyhole, start point, small radius point. So we can give in any direction. So this is small radius and a large radius. So this is our keyhole profile. Now next is hexagon. So in hexagon, we have to define a center of our hexagon. Suppose this is the center of our hexagon. Again, according to dimension, you just have to click the direction and proportion it to the origin, and with reference to any line, we can create our hexagon here. So this is our hexagon. Right. Then again, next command is a centered rectangle. So we have seen this is very first rectangle is normal rectangle which is made a diagonally, but in centered rectangle we'll make here a rectangle. So just click on the center. So you can see here the selection point is a center for rectangle. So again, you need to just give the direction where we need a rectangle. Suppose this is a rectangle. Again, here center rectangle. Suppose this is our center, then you can make here the rectangle. Right, and after that, our final is our last is centered parallelogram. So for centered parallelogram, we have to select here the two lines. So first line and second line. So according to that, it gives us a centered parallelogram. Again, first line, second line, centered parallelogram. So this is called as our predefined profile. This is called as our predefined profile. Predefined profile. These predefined profiles are available in a profile toolbar. This is very important tool for a sketcher. Without this toolbar, we cannot create any profile. So for that purpose, we need to study this profile toolbar. Now, again, clear the screen. Again, next command is our circle here. Circle. So again, there are the different types of circles are provided with us. The first one is circle. Just click on left click on the circle. Again, read our command from statement. Select a point or click to define the circle or center point of our circle here. So suppose this is our center point of circle, then circle. So you can easily draw the circle. Now again, if I am using this profile, suppose I am just drawing a simple triangle. The second circle is three point circle. So this meaning of for this 3-point circle is means we are passing a circle through 3 points. So suppose I am assuming that this is very first point, again this is our second point, and again this is our third point. So this circle is passing through this 3 end point of our triangle. So first one is our normal circle, in which we have to define the center point and a radius. 3-point circle, so this is first point, again second point, and the third point. So it is passing through this 3-point circle, right? Now next one is our circle using coordinates. We know that basically there are the three types of coordinate systems. First one is incremental coordinate system, second one is absolute coordinate system, and third one is polar coordinate system. So by using this three coordinate system, we can also create our profile. But for that process, we should know the coordinates of the each and every point of the elements. So see here, using coordinate system. So again, this is our horizontal. H stands for your horizontal and V stands for your vertical. How much distance are from horizontal and how much distance is from a vertical? So we are just giving here our dimension is suppose 100 mm from horizontal. So this is our horizontal dimensions, and 100 mm from vertical. So again, this is our vertical dimensions. And how much radius is required there? Suppose we are assuming that our value is a 50. Radius is 50. Click on OK here. So this is our 100 dimension is a horizontal and 100 is a vertical. I'll get here the radius is a 50. This green color is shows here the diagram is fully constrained, because all the dimensions are provided with reference to the origin, with reference to this horizontal and vertical axis. So again, using coordinate system. So this is very first one is our Cartesian coordinate system. If I'm talking about our polar coordinate systems, so in polar coordinate systems, again we have to define here the radius. Means suppose I am assuming that this is the radius of your 100. Suppose 100, this is our imaginary radius of the point. And how much angle is required there? So for that we are just providing 135 degrees Celsius, and a radius is again a 50. So click on the here. So again, look at this. This is the 135 degree angle, 100 mm radius, and this is the imaginary point of the circle, center point of our circle, where after 135 degree inclination. And what about the radius of our circle is 50 mm. This is the radius of our circle. So this is called as our Cartesian circle using coordinates. Next one is again a tri-tangent circle. So tri-tangent circle means what? Again, before going to start this command, I'll just clear this one. Circle, again this is circle, again this is circle. So tri-tangent circle, select this tri-tangent circle. Suppose I want to create a circle, that circle should pass through this tangent, again this tangent, and again this tangent. So this is very first tangent, second tangent, and third tangent. So select all the tangent. But if you are observing that the selection is also very important here, the direction of selection is very important here. Again, just observe very carefully, try tangent. So I am just selecting to the outer diameter of this circle, outer dimension or outer diameter of this circle. This is the inner diameter of our circle, and again outer diameter of our circle. So this pass through this three tangent, but the direction of our selection is very important. So this is the outer diameter, inner diameter and again outer diameter. So according to our selection, we'll get the output again. Tri-tangent circle. So select tri-tangent circle. First tangent, second tangent, and third tangent. So this is called as a tri-tangent circle. Now this is related to our circle command. So remaining commands we'll see in our next lecture. So I hope that you like this, all the basics tools of our profile toolbar. So if you like all this, so please kindly subscribe my channel. Thank you.